Now, what if gusto nyong pagandahin yung animation or you want to make it look more badass? Kasi right now, mukha siyang PowerPoint. Wala siyang kadating-dating. Paano kung gusto mo lagyan ng dating? Right? So, in After Effects, we have this thing called ease. Easy ease. Alright? So, ibig sabihin ng easy ease is nilalagyan niya ng ease in and ease out yung inyong files or layers or animation. So, paano siya gawin? You highlight your keyframes, right-click on the keyframe, you go to Keyframe Assistant, and then click on Easy Ease. If you want na mag-Easy Ease man ang automatic, click on it, press F9. Sir, what if nag-Easy Ease ako tapos parang ayoko palang mag-Easy Ease? So, yung itsura ng Easy Ease keyframe is yung mukhang hourglass. Yeah, thank you, thank you. So, if I press Control-Click... Hold control, sorry, and click with my left click on the hourglass, it turns back into the normal keyframe. So, again, I'll be teaching the F9. So, mag-F9 ulit ako para mag-easy ease siya. So, ang itsura ng easy ease right now, it's this. Alright? Kahit pa paano may ease na, pero pantay pa rin siya. Pantay yung animation, hindi siya ganun ka-effective. Okay? So, I'll be creating 3 para... mapakita ko yung difference nilang tatlo. So, yung nasa pinakataas, so I'll name it as no ease. With ease. With more ease. Okay? So, yung no ease looks like this. So, sa solo ko siya. Teka, yeah. Looks like this, di ba? Pag meron na siyang with ease, iba na yung itsura niya. Napansin nyo? Mas may delay yung with ease, tsaka mas smooth siya. So again, ito yung no ease, pantay. Ito yung with ease. Mas smooth, right? Now, ano tong nilagay kong more ease? So how do we do more ease? In After Effects, we have this thing called graph editor. Okay? So saan makikita yung graph editor? It's here on the top on the top of the timeline. If you click on it, you have the graph editor. Again, highlight your keyframes. Click on Graph Editor. At first, your Graph Editor will look something like this. Very techy, very scientist, nakakabuisit. Alright? So, how do we make it more simple? All you have to do is, here on the second icon, katabi nung I na icon, click on it, choose Graphs and Types yung pangalan. Choose Speed Graph. Edit Speed Graph. So, if you click on it, it becomes an arc. Alright? Sir, bakit paminsan wala akong nakikitang graph? The only reason is you're not selecting your keyframe. Kaya siya hindi nakikita. But if you select the keyframe, click on the graph editor, and then choose speed graph, it shows this. Sir, what if masyado siyang maliit or masyado siyang masikip? Just click on plus so that it expands. Alright? How do we edit the graph editor? So, i-explain ko siya in this sense. Okay? Horizontal is the time or the length of the keyframe, meaning it's 12 frames, yung length niya. Vertical is the speed of your keyframe. Okay? So, right now, it's very neutral, di ba? Gradual siyang umaakyat, pantay din yung pagbagal niya as it reaches the end of the keyframe. What if you want, sir, gusto ko, mabilis siyang aakyat, pero mas matagal siyang babagal? All you have to do is highlight, let's say, the end keyframe. And then you'll see a yellow handle. If you drag it to the left, it changes the peak of your speed. So, ang mangyayari, mas mabilis na siyang umaakyat, pero mas matagal na siyang bumababa. So, if you press play, it looks like this. Mabilis siya at first. Mabagal siyang nag-end. Okay? If I move it past ng sagad, yeah. The other side naman, if I make it na ito yung minove ko to the right, it gradually speeds up and then briskly speeds down. So again, ulitin ko lang. Bago tayo magpunta sa next step, ulitin ko yung graph editor. So, dapat meron ka ng animation from left to right. Dapat naka-ease na siya, F9. And then you go to Graph Editor. You go to the Choose Graph Type, Choose Speed Graph. And then, click on the handles, think of what you need. For example, gusto ko siya mabilis, mabilis siyang makakarating sa isang point bago siya mabagal na mag-end. So what I'll do is click on the highlight the end keyframe, move the handle to the left. Ang mangyayari, speed up, tapos gradual siya slow down. If I move it on the other side, gradual siyang speed up, tapos brisk siyang slow down. Whenever you do the graph editor thing pala, you can also do that for scale and rotation. So, baka malito kayo, gagawin ko na lang din ito. So, for example, may scale kang pabaliktad. So, 100 to 25. Pag hinighlight mo yung, pag in-F9 mo yan, tas hinighlight mo siya, silang dalawa, yung dalawang property, tas nag-graph editor ka, dalawa yung lumalabas. Okay? Dalawa. Paano mo malalaman kung alin sa kanila ang kailangan mo? Yung kulay nung value, yun yung kulay nung line. So, red, red, purple, purple. If nasa taas yung curve, it means it's on the positive. Meaning, paakyat yung number. If nasa baba, meaning negative yung number. So, for example, yung scale ko. Since nag-move ako, start keyframe 100 to 25, pababa siya. So, yung graph ko, baliktad. Pero same rin siya ng concept. So, yung graph niyan, pababa, negatively, pabilis. Ganun din siya. Hindi siya yung pinakamabagal. Ganun, ano siya. So, frequency siya. So, from the zero, meaning infinity, yung pinakataas, papakita ko na lang din. Yung both. Ayan. Ayan. Yung pinakataas, speed. Pinakababa, speed din siya. Fastest, fastest. Ganun siya, ha? And then, you can also adjust this if you need. So, yeah. For example, like that. You check the animation. It's like this.